The Portland native developed his considerable ball-striking skills as a youngster at Tualatin Country Club. Under the tutelage of then-PGA head golf professional Tim Berg, John perfected his powerful shoulder turn, which produced booming and accurate drives. While John's amateur career was relatively brief, it was nothing short of remarkable. With a victory in the Pacific Coast Amateur Championship at the famed Olympic Club in San Francisco, he immediately leaped onto the major amateur golf scene. By this time, John was also a standout player on Coach Carl Tucker's powerhouse Brigham Young University golf team. In 1976, he won two collegiate tournaments, and the Cougars were runner-up in the NCAA championship. His stellar collegiate season ultimately earned him NCAA first-team All-American honors. The summer of 1976 was a harbinger of things to come. John was low amateur at the U.S. Open at the Atlanta Athletic Club and would later go on to win the Northwest Open title by defeating fellow Oregonian and reigning Pac-10 champion Peter Jacobson in a thrilling down-to-the-wire battle at Portland's Columbia Edgewater Country Club. The summer would culminate with John being named to the OGA's Morse Cup team at the Pacific Coast Amateur, as well as Hudson Cup Amateur team. The USGA also selected him to represent his country on their four-man world amateur team in Portugal. Joining John on that team was current U.S. amateur champion Bill Sander of Seattle. As good as 1976 was for John, 1977 would be historic. Not since Bobby Jones' Grand Slam year of 1929 had an amateur golfer had a summer like Foote did that year. In July, he captured the coveted Trans-Mississippi Amateur in Texas over friend and two-time NC2A champion Scott Simpson. The next week, he beat defending champion Bill Leffler at the prestigious Broadmoor Invitational in Colorado Springs. At that time, the Trans-Miss and the Broadmoor were considered two of the premier amateur events in North America. In August, it was off to the U.S. Amateur Championship at Arana Mink Golf Club near Philadelphia. It was the golden ring John had set his sights on many months earlier. With his prodigious ball striking leading the way, he mastered the long Arana Mink layout and routed Indiana's Doug Fischer 9-8 in their final 36-hole match to claim amateur golf's most coveted prize. His victory was especially noteworthy, as at that time he was one of only four men from the Northwest to capture the U.S. amateur, the others being Bud Ward, Jack Westland, and Bill Sander. Of course, Jeff Quinney and Ryan Moore have recently also joined this illustrious group. Wow, what a list of players. There was still more glory in 1977, as John would lead the U.S. team to victory over the Great Britain and Ireland team in the Walker Cup matches at Shinnecock Hills Golf Club. Amazingly, over 3 months and four major competitions, John won 22 consecutive matches against the finest amateurs in the game. At the end of the year, Golf Digest magazine ranked him as America's number one amateur golfer. John would soon turn pro and earn his PGA Tour card. Success soon followed as he won back-to-back events in his first full season on the tour and was named Rookie of the Year. Sadly, a recurring injury would cut short a promising pro career. While sidelined, John turned his attention to golf course design and soon exhibited a passion and talent for the craft. A student of great architects such as Thomas, McKenzie, Ross, and Tillinghast, Foote would have a significant hand in creating Pumpkin Ridge Golf Club and the Crosswater Club while working alongside golf course architect Bob Cupp. He also did a redesign of his childhood course, Tualatin Country Club, which held special meaning for him. In recent years, under his own company, Scottsdale, Arizona-based John Foote Design, he's created some of the finest championship courses in North America, including Northwest Gems, Washington National Golf Club, Trophy Lake Golf and Casting, and the Reserve Vineyard and Golf Club. This year's Pacific Coast Amateur Championship will be contested at another Foote Design, the Gallery Golf Club in Tucson, Arizona, which is a unique honor for him as a past champion of the event. Today, John Foote is regarded as one of the finest golf course architects in the industry, and it's no wonder why. Yes, it's safe to say that whatever John Foote has done in the world of golf, it has been a great success. So please join the PNGA as we proudly induct John Foote into the Pacific Northwest Golf Hall of Fame.